I was kind of hesitant at first, but I will die on this hill. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Hannah. I'm your voice teacher. How are you? I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. Today we're doing something fun. We're ranking Disney theme songs. We're making a tier list. It's been a while since I made a tier list. I have been reacting to a lot of DCOMs recently. I did High School Musical, Camp Rock, Cheetah Girls. Oh my God, it's so fun. Oh, I did Descendants. But now we're going to the TV shows. I have a list of amazing shows. Most of them are from my childhood preteen years, but I did pick a couple that I haven't heard of or came after my Disney Channel time. So this is gonna be fun. Hey, guess what? This video is sponsored by Surfshark. Also, guess what? Your data is in danger. You're probably physically not in danger, but your data is... Okay, all right. Let's just talk. Mono and mono. I f***ing love Surfshark. Here's a fun story. I've purchased Surfshark. I purchased them a long time ago because I genuinely love them. And then they came back and were like, oh my God, we love your videos. Can we sponsor you again? And I was like... Pfft. Okay, fine. Surfshark is a VPN, a virtual private network, and it keeps you safe online. Your data is in danger, basically all the time. If you're not using a VPN, anybody can buy your data, and your internet provider can see everything you do online. What you're doing on the internet is none of my GD business, and it's none of your internet provider's business either. And that's where Surfshark comes in. Surfshark doesn't store, track, or monitor anything you do online, so you're safe, secure, and protected. Also, one of the reasons Surfshark is so rad, through their app or browser extension, you can mask your location so that you can access different content online. So just with a couple clicks, click, 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 you can change your location and you can start watching stuff that you want to watch on streaming services like Netflix, YouTube, any of those things. And Surfshark is the only VPN that allows you unlimited devices on one account. Surfshark. I know that you want your data protected. I know you want your privacy. And I know you want to have the same VPN that I have on all of my devices. It has been proven that Surfshark is the sexiest VPN of them all. Ooh, Surfshark. So use my link below, enter promo code Hannah for 83% off and an extra 3 months free. Always looking out for you, babe. Okay, let's see what we've got first. Oh, we got Lizzie McGuire. Here's the thing. I haven't listened to these theme songs in so long. I mean, since I watched them. Oh my God, the nostalgia. We only
do the best we can.
I remember it.
And sometimes we make it. Sometimes we fake it.
Just goofy, quirky things. Okay, here's the thing I'm realizing. The way that we rank these together, we're ranking them together with the collective consciousness, you and me. Time is but an illusion, so you're doing this with me. My views on the theme song do not necessarily represent my views on the TV show because I'm not gonna lie, I'm not wowed. I was hit with the nostalgia, but mostly from Hillary Duff's like platform flip-flops, not from the song. So I'm gonna put it in B tier just for now. Just a nice little B tier, I think is a safe place for Lizzie McGuire at this moment. Next. Shake It Up. Okay, this is one of the ones that I didn't really watch. Oh, look at Zendaya and Bella Thorne. They're so little. Okay. It's a bop. Is this the entire thing? It's long. Okay, Shake It Up. It was a bop. It was a jam. I couldn't help but like move a little bit and that was kind of fun and exciting. You know, gonna put it up at an A. It got me moving more than Lizzie McGuire. But you know, that could change. This is the beginning of our tier list. Okay, next. Do you guys remember the show, Sunny with a Chance? I watched this show. Wasn't there only like one season? Off to the races, I'm going places. Oh my gosh, I remember it. Yeah. Oh, and Demi Lovato sounds great. Oh my gosh. Okay. My Demi bias is coming through. Okay. I actually think that that needs to replace Shake It Up at this moment. That was kind of everything I wanted. And I'm going to put Shake It Up next to Lizzie. Actually, I'm going to move Lizzie McGuire down there. Oh my God. I'm so sorry. It just feels right. I don't know. I'm just going with the vibes. Collective unconscious, right? Like you guys were feeling it too. I know you were. Okay, next. The Proud Family. Oh my God. I fucking loved this show. I was 9 and I watched it all the time. I loved it. The Proud Family. What? You and me will always be. It's Destiny's Child. And they throw in those harmonies. Aww. Oh my God, Proud Family, straight to the top. Straight to the top. Guys, did you hear that? Were we all just jamming out to that? I also kind of think Destiny's Child like brings it up to A at least just by the fact that Beyonce is singing on it. I mean, what other show can say that? All right, well, if we're going with pop stars, let's do Wizards of Waverly Place. Here's what's interesting. There's an original and there's a final version. There was an old theme song for Wizards of Waverly Place. We must listen to both of them. Okay, here's the original version. Well, you know everything's gonna be a breeze. At the end, we'll no doubt justify. Oh, immediately taken back to my teenage years. Okay. Yep. But it seems. I know we don't really have a criteria of how we're like judging them. Wow, I really am acting like we are doing this together. But I have to say, I liked that one, the music matched the kind of like magical vibe of the show. And that was kind of fun. But that was the original one, which I remember. So what is the final one? Oh, they remixed it. Well, you know, everything's gonna be a breeze. Then we'll no doubt justify the means. Okay, real talk. I had the biggest crush on David Henry. I thought he was so cute. That's what I said. Okay. What it seems when you can get it now feels like a dance jam. Okay, so I did kind of like that turned it into like a club jam, but that seemed like a very lazy intro. They just like edited clips of them into a crystal ball. I think we're supposed to just be ranking these based on the song itself, but I'm kind of inclined to include the video too. But the original was bomb. So Wizards of Waverly Place, I think it's gonna go right next to Shake It Up. I feel good about that. How do you guys feel? Okay, good. I'm glad that we all agree. Oh boy. Kim Possible. Do, 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 do. God, I already remember. I could sing it to you right now. Oh, yeah. I'm your basic average girl, and I'm here to save the world. Just your basic average girl. I will never get tired of that. I'm just your basic average girl and oh no, I have superpowers or I'm just really good at hand-to-hand combat because of my cheer training. Doesn't matter where or when there's trouble. The vocals are great. So what's the sitch? I might start answering the phone like that. Okay, the vocals on that one? Who sings that? Christina Milian? Really? Oh, okay. Well, yeah, it was amazing. I loved that. You know, I'm gonna put it in B for now. No, it's gotta go in A. I don't have anything for S yet. Yet. I might rearrange. Okay, guys. We need another classic. That's So Raven. Oh my God, I'm having a really great time. This is fun. That's So Raven was also one of my favorite shows. I just reacted to the Cheetah Girls, so this is very appropriate. Let's go. You could gaze into the future. You might think life would be a breeze. I love that part. Life is a breeze. Amazing. Come on and ride with Ray Hale. And if the future looks great now, then everything's gonna change. Oh my God.
That's me.
Ah, this one's so good. I kind of Guys, right? It's got to be an S tier. It's so good. And also, I mean, maybe I am remembering just how much I love the show, but it's so good. If you could gaze into the future. S tier, absolutely. I was kind of hesitant at first, but I will die on this hill for S tier. Next, y'all. A show I didn't really watch. Jesse. Okay, this video has the lyrics on it. I literally just had to check the playback speed to see if I was playing this too fast. This is what? This is the theme song? Because it sounds like her voice has been pitched up, which happens when you speed up, like audio up, the voices get higher, like chipmunks. And it sounds like that just slightly. I mean, it's coming from the auto-tune, but interesting. That was just cute at the end. All right, guys. Can you tell what my opinion is based on my face? I don't really like that one. I didn't feel like it was very catchy. I gotta put it in D. I mean, I like the, hey, Jesse. That makes sense. It's called Jesse. You know, doesn't have to be complicated. You just get right to the point. I just didn't really want to jam out to it. And I got confused. And I thought that her voice sounded a tiny, teeny bit chipmunky. So I feel like it's only fair that it goes on a D tier. Okay, this one you know is going to be good. Phineas and Ferb. We know this. We all know this theme song. Building a rocket or fighting a mummy. You're climbing up the Eiffel Tower. It's over here. I watched a lot of this. So stick with us, 'cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. That was fun. I did watch a lot of this. I was in high school when this came out. It's really funny. If it was on TV at a hotel that I was staying in, I wouldn't change the channel. So that's a compliment. Who has 104 days of summer vacation? That's over 3 months. Who has that much summer vacation? I mean, I feel like you should. Oh my God. Okay. I feel like I'm going to put Phineas and Ferb right now for NA and then maybe move it up to S. I might move it up to S. I'm going to wait and think. Y'all, Liv and Maddie. Okay, this was after my Disney time, but I watched it on Netflix when I was, I don't know, a few years ago, 9 years ago. What? How old am I? And I really liked it. I really like this song. Say yeah. I say no. No. Oh, I don't know the words very well. I'm sorry, we have to just talk about this still. They lit this so badly. It looks like they're the same person on different days, which is crazy because we know that they're obviously twins. This one's hard because it is a bop, but I actually like the song a lot better when Liv, she sings it at like towards the end of the first season, I think, and she sings it like acoustic and it's really pretty. So I like the song. I just am not a fan of that intro. Oh God, guys, I think I'm going to put it in C next to Lizzie McGuire. It has so much potential, but I'm just not feeling it. It's just not right. Okay, next we've got Austin and Ally. This is a show that I have never seen. I know that Ross Lynch is in it and I just reacted to Teen Beach Movie 1 and 2, if you want to go watch that. And I know that he's a great singer, but I don't know anything about the show. So I bring on the thunder, 'cause you got my back and I'm not going under. You're my point, you're my god, you're the perfect chord, and I see our names together on every billboard. That's not what I expected. I like that. Aw, man, I'm not impressed. I didn't feel like that said anything about what the show is about. I still have no idea. I mean, there's music notes in the logo. So like, are they musicians? I assume he was playing the guitar. I was kind of ready for it to be over about 10 seconds in. So D tier, Austin and Ally, D tier. Did you guys watch this show? KC Undercover? I never watched this one. Look how cute Zendaya is. How long was this show on air? Swear to God, I have never heard of this show. Okay. I keep it undercover. Living my life on red alert. Doing my thing, I'll make it work. Know I'm the realest, maybe I'm fearless. This is really good. Nobody can do it like I can. I gotta find out. She sounds so good. I keep it undercover. Zendaya, what the heck? It was so good. The vocals are really pushing it up for me because she sounds so good. It was like not what I would call like a bop, but I was definitely feeling it. Like, you know, my head was moving slightly to the beat. Casey Undercover is going to go next to Wizards of Waverly Place on B tier. For now, I feel good with where that's at. Do we need to make any adjustments? I'm starting to think Sunny with a Chance needs to go down a little bit. And, you know... okay, we're gonna do an adjustment. Shake It Up, you're going down here. Sorry, babes. Sorry, Shake It Up. Liv and Maddie, do I wanna do it? Yeah, I do. Liv and Maddie, go to the top. Well, of B tier. Go to B tier. Good job. Sunny with a Chance. Does it need to move? I'm gonna keep it in A tier for now, okay? Sunny with a Chance is gonna stay. We'll reevaluate at the end, okay? Oh my God, guys. Phil of the Future. Who watched this? This was one of my favorite shows when I was a kid. Please comment down below if you watched Phil of the Future. I loved it. Also, I had a huge crush on Ricky Ullman. I had crushes on everybody. Please don't say that that makes sense because I'm a Libra, all right? That's a stereotype that I don't prove correct. Need a boy named Phil and his family. Well, I remember the show being really good. Okay, guys, we've got Hannah Montana. I reacted to the first episode of Hannah Montana. If you guys want to watch me react to that, I'll link it over here. Yes. Look at her. Ooh, when you're famous, it can be kind of fun. Show meant to play this part, honestly. Know that it's the best of both worlds. Oh my god, guys, come on. S tier Hannah Montana, that is iconic. It's so good. It's a jam. The words are still stuck in my head. I think that's a sign. If I still remember the words really well, it is a good theme song. Guys, this is our last one, The Suite Life of Zack and Cody. Are we ready for this? Kim Rhodes was the star of the show. I loved her. It's Phil of the Future vibes. It's not very pleasant on my ear. I was about to say earballs. I don't have earballs. But if I did, it would not be pleasant. I would be getting kicked in the earballs right now. Okay, we need to do some rearranging. The thing is, Phil of the Future and Suite Life of Zack and Cody, I think, deserve to be on D tier. And so does Austin and Ellie. The D tier is reserved to those theme songs that I did not want to listen to. My earballs said, no, thank you. I think I'm going to move Jesse up. I don't think Jesse deserves to be in the D tier. C tier, Lizzie McGuire, Shake It Up, Jesse. Okay, I feel pretty good about that. Casey Undercover on a B tier. Oh yeah, we need to do some rearranging because I think Casey Undercover needs to be up here on an A. Phineas and Ferb, absolutely S tier. S tier all the way. We're putting him up there. Sunny with a Chance. Ah, Sunny, baby. I'm so sorry. I got to put you down there. Kim Possible, I'm still going to keep on an A tier. Apparently this is like A tier is the secret agent tier. How fun. Kim Possible and Casey Undercover together. Liv and Maddie. No, I feel good about this. The Proud Family, I kind of... oh, man. No. That's staying on S. Nope. Stick with your guns. Da-da-da-da! This is my tier list of Disney theme songs. I did not cover every one that I could. So let me know if you want me to make another one of these. If so, what are the shows you want me to put on the tier list? Do you disagree with me? Tell me in the comments. Let's fight it out. Come on. Defend your position. I'm really not aggressive. Don't worry. Thanks again to Surfshark for sponsoring this video. Use my link below, enter promo code Hannah for 83% off and 3 extra months for free. Until next time, I'm Hannah. I'm your voice teacher, and now you're all my students. Lucky you. Check out my TikTok and Instagram, why don't you? At hannah.bales. Check out my Patreon, patreon.com/hannahbales. Why don't you do that? That's a great idea. I'm so glad you thought of it. Check out my merch shop if you want to wear a rad sweatshirt. We're not restocking these, so grab them while you can. Grab them while they're hot and cool. And I'll see you guys later. Okay, bye.